Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome to Repair and Replace. Conventional stoves use coiled heating elements, which are exposed on the cooktop. If the burner doesn't heat up with an orange glow spread evenly around the coil, then it's time to replace it. In this episode, first, we'll learn how it all works. Then, we'll test the heating element. Finally, we'll see how to install a replacement. Let's get started. Electric stoves are pretty simple at a base level. When electricity passes through the heating element, the resistance in the material generates heat. Each burner is on a separate circuit and is controlled by an infinite heat switch. When you turn the dial, the switch closes, letting 120 volts travel through both sides of the element. This provides the necessary 240 volts. One side of the switch will remain closed, which will power the cooktop indicator light. The other side of the switch will open and disconnect power once the element heats up. It will cycle on and off to maintain the set level of heat. Over time, heating elements can burn out and fail completely. A continuity test will determine if there's a continuous path for electricity to flow through. Without continuity, there is no resistance, and the element will not heat up. Additionally, a faulty heat switch or damaged wires can also prevent the element from receiving power. You can see how to troubleshoot this further in the video linked below. First, lift up the element and remove it. Now check the terminals. If they are covered in a black soot, then clean the terminals. If the terminals look pitted or damaged, then it's best to replace the element. Blackened terminals are also a sign that the receptacle is worn out. You can see how to replace the receptacle in the video linked below. One quick way to test the element is to swap it with another one. If the second element works in this receptacle, then you know that the original was faulty. Now, if the second element doesn't heat up, then it's likely a problem with the switch or the wiring. To be certain that the element has failed, you can also do a continuity test. Set your multimeter to the ohms or resistance setting. Now touch the probes to each terminal. If the element is good, it'll have a resistance of around 20 to 45 ohms. Now, if there is no reading and no continuity, or if the resistance is far outside of that range, then replace the element. Keep in mind, stoves that are made after 2018 have elements with a built-in limiter to prevent overheating. These are still tested and replaced in the same way. Heating elements are either 6 or 8 inches wide. They come in a variety of wattages, which are usually printed on the side. To know which element you'll need, enter your model number on the AMRE Supply website. From there, you'll see a parts breakdown with the exact replacement parts listed for your model. To install the new element, align the terminals and push it into place. Make sure that the mounting bracket lines up with the slots on the drip bowl. Finally, turn on the cooktop to test the new element. For more troubleshooting videos on water heaters, furnaces, and appliances, then subscribe to our channel. And if you need help, you can call or visit an AMRE location to talk with our knowledgeable staff. Thanks for watching.